I was 15 years old, and I saw a cover, a magazine called Muscle and Fitness. And on the cover was Reg Park, a British bodybuilding champion who won the Mr. Universe competition 3 times. And I got really inspired by his story, that how he trained 5-6 hours a day, became Mr. Universe, and then got to be the Hercules, the star of Hercules movies. And so I wanted to have exactly the same career. So I started training 5-6 hours a day and became a fanatic about it.
You got to have a goal. I mean, if that's the goal, you have to have a very clear vision. Because to go in the direction that I went takes a lot of work. And I don't think that you can do the work, the 5 hours of working out a day, or 6 hours sometimes, if you don't have a clear goal and you know why you're doing it. To just hang out in the gym and train five hours a day without a goal is almost impossible. And then what I went through when I went to America, you know, to educate myself over there and to work and to grind it out and to work your way up in Hollywood, which is very, very difficult. All of those things are very hard, so you have to be very determined. But the most important thing is you have to have your goal always in front of you so you know what you're fighting for. Then it is fun. I always had fun doing all of those things because I knew why I was doing it, and I was absolutely convinced that I will get there, no matter what anyone said, because my whole life everyone always said, it can't be done, you will never do it, you will fail. No one has ever done it, to go from Austria and be a Mr. Universe and blah, 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 and all this stuff. So, I mean, I've heard all the it's impossible thing, and I didn't pay any attention because I believed that I could do it.
It's drive. It's the will. There's certain people that grow up with a tremendous hunger, and it's usually kids that have struggled when they were kids. When you grow up comfortably and in comfort and in peace and happiness and all those things, that will produce a very balanced person and a good person, but it will not create the will and the determination and the hunger that you need to be the best in the world.
My parents really thought that there was something terribly wrong of being that driven, you know, because I would come home at lunchtime and then instead of having lunch, I would do 200 sit-ups. And at night, I would go to the stadium and I would be lifting weights. I would come home at 10 o'clock at night and I would be continuing lifting weights. So it was like one of this insanity in the military. I would continue lifting weights. No matter how the training was and how tough the basic training was, I would always then lift weights afterwards. And as a tank driver, I would have on the side of the tank in the toolbox, I would have my weights, my barbells, and my dumbbells, and my exercise bench and everything there, in order to be at any given time, if we stopped driving the tank and maneuvers at 2 in the morning, I would be able to pull out my weights and again lift for 2 hours my weights. So I was really a fanatic about the whole thing. But it's the only way you really get where the way I succeeded, because I became at the age of 20 the youngest Mr. Universe in London in the history of bodybuilding, because the youngest before then was Reg Park, the guy I was talking about, with the age of 24, that I became the youngest with 20, but it was because I was like so serious about the whole thing, and it worked.
In a way, even the day when I won the 7th Mr. Olympia title, I felt like, you know, I was not in great shape. So I was always so hungry for perfection and so hungry for being bigger and better and lifting more and performing better and all those things. I think you need that in order to be successful, in order to really be extraordinary in the profession that you do. If you're happy with just anything, it's not going to motivate you enough to really work for it.
The most important thing is you have to have a vision. You have to know where you're going. I mean, I knew very clearly at the age of 14, 15 that I want to be a world champion in bodybuilding. So, and I was absolutely convinced that I'm going to win that title. In that vision.
Well, in bodybuilding and in lifting, you know that it's all about reps. In life, it's all about reps. The more you practice something, the better you get. If it is you know, practice a poem, if it is practice on your job here, whatever it is, it's all about mileage and it's all about reps. And there's no shortcut. And if you ever look for the shortcut or for
kind of like getting around and finding some easier way, you're fooling yourself. Because in the end, it's always the people that are willing to work the hardest and that are willing to get in the trenches and to do the reps and to work hard and to look at the day, that the day is 24 hours. 6 hours we sleep, so you've left 18 hours. So don't ever give me this thing that, oh my God, I'm working 12 hours and I don't have time to exercise and to work out, or I don't have time to study another language and all this kind of thing. You have, 18 hours. And so utilize the 18 hours well. And that's really what I always believed in. And I feel like that's the only way you can get ahead. If you have a very clear vision where you want to go, and if you're willing to put the work in, no matter what it takes, to get them to turn this vision into reality.
Dream. I was poor because I didn't have anything. I had no money, I had no things, we had no TV, we had no refrigerator, we had nothing as kids. But I was rich because I had a dream. Dream.